So on the same note, on the same point, I know for a fact that there are like legally allowed applications available on Google Play Store that put out all these books for free. There are websites that are active on Google server, on google.com. You don't have to use any VPN or something, just one click and you're away from all the books in the world. They are available for free. They are available to download and read for free, unlimited access. I want to know that the book market is a huge market. There are big names involved. There are big businesses involved. There are big money involved. Why doesn't this entire machinery of the book market legally shut down all these people who run these applications or who run these websites? Why is it impossible to legally shut them down?
True. So, see, I think one very big factor here is the copyright free books. So when you don't have a copyright on your text, anyone can kind of copy it, use it, and say that, hey, this is for free. That is a very big legal clause that a lot of authors are just not aware of. When they start writing, they're like, hey, it's okay, I am gonna give this to the publisher. It's upon them how they want to publish it. But that's wrong, right? Being an author, you have to take complete ownership of what you have written. That's one. Second is also the consumption. So you really need to kind of, stop the usage of plagiarized books, going and downloading free books. That really needs to stop, because that's when they're not going to have a market. So it's more than legal. It's, I think, something that we as readers have to imbibe in ourselves. As much as it seems that, hey, that international book that I was getting for 600 on Amazon, I can get it on a plagiarized website for free. I'm going to get it. We need to stop having that lucrative thing in mind. So it's more about the consumption that needs to stop. And of course, the copyright fact is a very important legal aspect.
Okay, so I had not expected this copyright thing to come. So hold on. The copyright point, I got it that as a writer, you need to protect your work. But I know of big names, and I'm pretty much sure that the publication house is taking care. So they have in place all the rights, all the copyright thing and all. Still,
Sure,
their books
sure.
are published and uploaded on these plagiarized websites.
Okay.
What you answered from the reader's point of view, that as a reader, you should have the courtesy to purchase the book. I get it, and I completely support it. But from the marketing standpoint, from the business
The
standpoint of the
publisher's
writer,
point.
yeah, why can't they legally, shut these books down or challenge these legally and get their business approval?
Right. See, so I think there are a lot of permutation and combinations when we talk about legal rights, right? So there are books that are completely free to be used by anyone and everyone, like all the classics right now. I think it's about 60 plus years, you kind of lose the copyright on it, right? So that is one reason anyone can download a book and say, hey, I've written it and I'll be publishing it for free. That is one reason. Also, there are a couple of other things also, I'm sure, that are in the background which everyone can play around. For a fact that when you have to do something and you know how to play around the words, you can kind of do it in the legal base as well. So I think that's the primary reason. I am unsure about the fact that, as you asked, that why the bigger publishers, when their books get plagiarized, how can they not control it? So that I am really unsure about. I don't really have a clue about that.